Hello, and welcome to the Java SE 8 Lambdas and Streams Massive Online Open Course. When Java SE 8 was released last year, it included a number of significant new features. In fact, JDK 8 is the biggest change to the platform since its launch nearly 20 years ago. The syntax of the language can now support Lambda expressions, and class libraries now contain the new Stream API. These features enable you to program in a more concise, flexible way that can take advantage of multiple cores and CPUs in your machine. To help you understand how to use these new features, we've created a 3-week massive open online course that is completely free. In the first week, we'll explain why we need Lambda expressions in Java and why we have added this feature after 20 years to the language. We'll talk about the syntax of Lambda expressions, where and when you can use them, and we'll explain the rules that govern their use. Then we'll give you some examples of where you can use them, places like the Collections API, which has new methods, such as removeIf and replaceAll. In the second week of the course, we'll introduce the Stream API itself, which makes extensive use of Lambda expressions to define behaviors when you use methods like filter, map, and reduce. We'll also show you how to create streams, the way you obtain stream sources, whether it's from a collection, from a buffer reader, a zip file, a jar file, and so on. We'll talk about how to use intermediate operations, things like filter and map, but other ones as well. And then we'll discuss how to get a result from your stream using terminal operations. The other thing we're going to talk about in this part of the course is the optional class, which again is new in JDK 8. This class makes it easier to avoid null pointer exceptions when, for example, we're attempting to find the maximum value in a stream, but the stream doesn't have any elements. In the final week, we're going to look at some more advanced topics related to streams. We'll discuss how to optimize our code in terms of using parallel streams, the details of collectors, and we'll also look into how to use reductions correctly. At the end of the course, you'll receive a certificate of completion, verifying you've completed all of the modules and exercises. Last year, we ran a MOOC for embedded Java, which was very popular. We're really hoping that this course is going to be even more successful, so please sign up and find out how to use these great new features in Java. Thank you.